I guess you can. I mean, definitely you can. It's all based on your qualifications. You know, one of the major criteria that we look at, first of all, is obviously what type of equity position you have in your current home. And, you know, as an example, if you have a house that's worth $400,000 and you owe $200,000 mortgage on it, you have $200,000 equity in your house, you can access that equity, absolutely. If you have investments that, you know, the house is worth $400,000, or sorry, it's worth $375,000, and you're going to mortgage $300,000 on it, you're not going to be able to access that equity line. You know, traditionally what lenders are going to allow you to do, you can finance up to 75 to 80% before Canada Mortgage and Housing kicks in. So that way you can access that way. The other criteria to borrow more money is your total debt service ratio. And it needs to be within the lender's guidelines. And that encompasses all your entire debt, including mortgage debt, and if you have rental properties, based on your income, based on your rental income, and have certain ratios that factor into that. One of the key things though is every lender has their own set of rules when it comes to buying investment properties or qualification purposes. So it varies from lender to lender. And what we're able to do is obviously to make sure that you have, you can shop the different marketplaces to make sure that you know that doesn't work with one lender, it can hopefully your qualifications can work in a different lender because they each have their own set of rules. It's not a blank set of rules across the board. Also, what gets more trickier is if you own more properties, the financing does become a lot more trickier to get more money out. And we have found even people that are debt servicing or they have trade ratios on, if they own 10 or so properties and they got good income, banks start to treat this more as commercial lending. So it becomes a lot more difficult sometimes to get more financing depending on how you have it structured and set up. So in summary, yes you can, and it really depends on obviously on how much debt you have, how much your income, and what your investment income is. And the final one is, which you gotta make sure, you gotta have a good credit rating today. So make sure you make all your minimum payments on the book, but you gotta have a good credit rating.
Thank you very much.